Children are the most vulnerable and affected victims of poverty. Like most of our people, these families have the same concerns for their children as you and I do. We want to raise our children in a healthy environment where they can be educated, taught moral and ethnic values, and provide safety and security for our children so they can pursue the happiness and life that they deserve. In a country like Bangladesh, children are the first to become victims of child labor. Sabiqun Nahar lives in a Lampara slum in Silet with her mother. Their main support, her father, died when she was only 13 months old. Her mother became the sole bread earner for the family. Although Sabiqun Nahar's mother was able to marry again, and despite their hardships, she chose to devote her life to raising her daughter. There are no sufficient public schools in Bangladesh, so the only choice parents have is to enroll their children into private schools. Sabiqun Nahar's mother wanted to put her in school, but the private school tuition was so high that she could hardly afford it. She took another job as a maid to earn extra money so she could send Sabiqun Nahar to school. She wants her daughter to overcome the tough cycle of poverty through education. And one day, she came to know about Uripon, a school run by Bidish Foundation. Sabiqun Nahar has been admitted into the school, and alhamdulillah, she is now in second grade. As we provide more children with an education, we realize that to raise a well-rounded child, you need to make sure all their habits are healthy and safe. There are thousands of kids living in poor conditions in these slums. They sacrifice their smile to make their parents happy. Iman also lives in a slum. His home is a narrow box shape, dark and gloomy. He shares a toilet with hundreds of other people. Iman's father died when he was a little boy. His mother used to work long hours to support him. He also attends Uripon and dreams to one day become a doctor. Inshallah, he will achieve this dream. Uripon Academy's ratings are high. The school has more than a 95% pass rate. Most of the students attending the school are from different slums. Along with education, the school provides nutritional lunches, school supplies, books, school dresses, and shoes. Saim began attending our school in first grade. He is now in seventh grade and has well improved his communication skills. After contemplation of his education, he has decided he wants to be a defense officer in order to serve his country. This is Robbie. He is only 6 years old. His father abandoned the family when he was an infant, and since then his mother has been looking after them. His home is not safe to live in. When it rains heavily, water leaks into the house. There's no clean drinking water in the slum, and hygienic restrooms are limited. There are many more children like Rabi, Alamgir, Uzal, Gulsum, and many more. They all have similar stories, similar struggles. One day, all of them will have to choose between school and child labor. Education and the cycle of poverty.
তারা একটু সুযোগ পাইলে দুটা পয়সা ইনকাম করার জন্য হয়তো কোনো গ্যারেজে অথবা কোনো দোকানে এখানে সেখানে কাজ করে, এই জন্য অনেক সময় স্কুলে আসে না। মেয়েদের বেলায় হয়তো দেখা যায় তাদের মা কোনো বাসায় জির কাজ করে, এখন তার মা একটু অসুস্থ, তখন মায়ের পরিবর্তে ওই মেয়েরা তখন অন্যদের বাসায় যায়, যার কারণে তারা স্কুলে অনেক সময় আসে না।
we believe everyone needs a safe and well-established community to raise a child. Please lend a hand today and make the life of one of these kids better tomorrow.